So you're talking about actions you can take. You've given some tangible examples. You've demonstrated, hey, here's some of how we've changed the building industry. But there are probably some myths out there that we could talk about, you know, the cost of these sorts of efforts that you would put on, et cetera. Yeah. So can you just talk about maybe some of those common myths and how you address them?
Well, you address every myth by turning the lights on a bit brighter and shining the pathway forward. So folks say, hey, if we put in a building code regime, it's just going to add too much cost. So I look at a place like Moore, Oklahoma. And Moore, Oklahoma went from having no building code, they had experienced yet another one of these large EF4, EF5 tornadoes. And so they adopted the most recent code. And you know what? It did add price. About $1.50 per square foot at the point of new construction. It wasn't free. But if you're building a 2,000 square foot home and bringing it all the way up to code brought $3,000 worth of cost, you might say that's not unreasonable. We look at the point of how do I make my roof more resilient in these elements? Well, you know, roofs can be expensive. Whether you're taking an asphalt shingle approach or a metal roof kind of person, you might spend $15,000 or more to re-roof in that space. When you go to seal the roof deck, that simple action to guard against water intrusion, it's $500. Like, oh, well, that's not so far out of reach. We look at the actions related to wildfires. We'll tell folks you need to put vent covers in place, the mesh, to make sure the embers don't get inside. It's a do-it-yourself project. It costs about $50 if you want to go to Lowe's or Home Depot to get the pieces that are there. It's not free, but I think that the return on it is priceless, because we've watched in too many places after that, when your CAT team gets deployed, and you're going to meet customers, and they're going to have their claims paid, and they should have confidence in that space. But I have never talked to someone who had their claim paid, who thought their life was better on the other side. They always come back and go, you know, financially they made me whole, but my life got disrupted. My neighborhood got ripped apart. If I could do anything just to go back and have my home and my belongings the way they were, I'm like, we can lay out a path. It really helps folks in that kind of space. And I think we've got to illuminate for more folks that these incremental actions are achievable in a way that might actually benefit them at a point related to their insurance. But most importantly, they're going to have a home to return to.